In the last video, we saw how to create tables and chairs. Before closing that part of the simulation elements, I want to show you a specific context in which we can work a different way instead of using the table tool, using another one we already know, but to create seats, okay, several seats. Now, we have here an example of a stadium tribune, okay? So you go to see, to watch a match, and then, well, here you have several people. Imagine you have a stadium, okay? Bigger, smaller, but, well, that's the idea. How can we create here seats? How we can populate these with characters seated and interacting? So we could use the table tool. So let's click on the table tool. Well, we get close and we start creating our chairs. Okay. Left click and drag, left click and drag, left click and drag, and so on and so forth. Now, right click to close. As you can see, here I would take a bit of time to fill everything. So, okay, we could do this. But in this case, where the seats are all regular and at the same distance and same dimension, same size, we could try a different way, a different method, okay? So we are not going to use the table tool. So just left click and delete. We are going to use a tool we already know, but it's not exactly meant for this. And this is the area tool. Okay, so here, the area tool. Instead of clicking on the area tool itself, the icon, let's click on this little arrow and choose the polygon creation. This way, I'm going to show you a different way of starting the area tool. Okay, an area in this case, or a square, as it's called also in Anima. Okay, something like this. Okay, a bit more, and that's it. So we are going to create this, the vertices that creates the shape. So, like this, and like this. Very simple. Right click to end it, and here we have our area tool. Okay? So, just let me adjust this. Okay? A bit here. And that's it. Now, area tool here. As you probably remember, when we were working with the area tool, I told you try to avoid creating areas on stairs. Well, actually, this is what we are going to do now. Okay, so what happens when we create areas on stairs? Well, people are created and socializing on stairs. So it's possible, yes. But in this case, we are going to twist it a bit. Okay, first thing first, I'm going to assign the characters I want to use here, here in this crowd. Okay, so I'm going to use, since it's something for where people are having a fun time, so we'll choosing, okay, two guys and three girls. Okay, so just left click and drag them here. Okay, so we don't exceed the limit. Actor count, well, here for example, fill all slots, 40 available. Okay, so let's talk about how we will distribute and position these characters. Now, we want exactly each character to be seat or placed on top of each seat. Now, I know the sizes of these seats, of this model. Each seat has a width of 55 centimeters, okay? This. And then there is a distance of 1 meter between the rows, okay? This one, and this one, and this one. This is all regular, obviously. If we would have, let's say, something more irregular, we probably should have to use more areas or even the table tool. Okay, so this is a specific case, but very interesting. So what we are going to do is to work with the grid of the area. Okay, so we select the area, we go to enable placement grid, and we set it to yes. We should have it to yes because it's the default option, okay? And then we work with the cell size placement grid because we are using the grid to place the characters, okay? And then the cell size ratio. Now, the cell size is 1 meter. So at the moment, we are using square cells. So the sides are all 1 meter long, Okay? And this is it, and this is this way because the cell size ratio is 1. It means that the two sides have the same length. Okay? But we know at this moment that we have two different sizes. 55 centimeters, which is the width of a seat, and then 1 meter, which is the distance between the rows of the seats. Okay? So the cell size ratio has to be changed to 0.55. Okay? And as you can see, we create cells of 1 meter by 55 centimeters. Okay? Now, one important thing we need to do is to position correctly. Well, at the moment it seems, say that we have this placed this way. We should have all the vertical lines going downward, right in the middle between the seats, as you can see here. This, this, this. Okay? I will adjust these vertices here just to be a bit more. Well, this is okay. Okay? That's very simple. Now, we know that in a socializing area, the characters are created in the center of the grid. So, the actor count now, for example, fill all slots proposes me to populate with 64 characters for 64 cells. Okay? I don't want to fill everything. I don't want the distribution to be too even on one side, and on the other side, I don't want to have too many characters at the moment in my viewport. Because my computer, my GPU probably couldn't handle it too well. Perhaps on your computer and with your GPU, this would be perfectly fine, okay? So each one of you have to try. So I will set the actor count to 45. And now generate. So I will have my characters. And of course, they will be standing. Why is that? Well, this is the default option, okay? If we go to the square properties on the right, we have the motion clip category assigned with the square category, okay? Which is several standing animation, okay? For conversations and so on. But we want them sit. So what we are going to do is going to the library motion clips and assign, instead of the square category, the chair category. Okay, so let's click on the chair category and drag it on top of this. And as you can see, all these characters are sit. But they are not facing the right direction. Okay, so how we control the direction towards which the characters are pointing at in an area? Well, we have to use the focus mode option. And at the moment, it's set to focus. We have to change this to grid. And as you can see, this changes a lot. Okay, this is a lot more what we want. Now, I want to point out where the characters are sitting. Okay, they're sitting on top of these lines, not in the center of the cells, but on top of these lines here. So what we could do is just to move the something like this to have the character more better sit on each chair or stand. Okay, the only problem I have here is that I have these characters here I don't want. So how we can remove them? Well, we select these vertices here and we reduce that space. Okay, we set it like this. We need to click generate to remove them, but at the same time, okay, I want more characters here, so I have to do exactly the opposite, okay? Give the area more space. So now I select the area, I click generate again, and now it's a lot better, okay? Remember one thing, we could set to yes key positions and rotations if we like the distribution, and then just each time we click generate, it will change the texture colors, models, but the positions and rotations would kept the same. Okay, will be kept. So at the same at this time, generate, let's see, a couple of times. No. Well, this is fine. So I will set keep position and rotations to yes. Perfect. Now, not exactly perfect. If I hit spacebar, well, they're sit, they're waiting, probably before the match, something like this. But what happens during the match? Probably there would be more movement, okay? Celebrating or something like this. So how we can change this? Well, we should change the animations. So here, in my case here, I have two more, three more categories, okay? Two called tribune. Well, I will assign the first one, the tribune, here to the square properties, where is the motion clip category. And now, if I hit spacebar, now that's it. This is what I was talking about, okay? A lot better. So, as you can see, it's very, very simple. Now, what about the other side? Let's say that here is the winning team, and on the other side we have the losing team. So, here are celebrating, on the other side, probably not. So what we should do is to copy this area. We are not going to recreate it. We are going to use what we already have. We copy it, but we are going to copy it in a new way. Quite useful one. Usually what we do is just to Control-C, Control-V, and then position it, or use the clone option. In this case, we are going to use the manipulator, okay? Usually, in this case, we are going to left-click and drag to move this area in the Y-axis direction. But if we do this while pressing the Shift key, we create a copy. For those coming from 3ds Max, this is actually, or Unreal Engine, this is actually something they already know. Okay, so this is very, very useful. Okay, we just have to position well the area according to the grid and the seats, and that's it. Now, the point is here that I don't want the same distribution, I don't want the same animations, so I will change this. Here I will set to no the key positions and rotations, so we'll click generate now. I will, let's say, something like this. That's okay. And I will change the motion clip category setting. So I will assign the tribune to like this. These are a bit sad. So I will hit spacebar, and as you can see, they are winning, they are not. Probably losing, something like this, okay? So as you can see, it's very, very simple. Once we created one area to copy and paste and just change a couple of options, and we have a different situation, okay? Now we'll do one more thing. I will add one more element, which is a path, okay? It will start from here, going back here, and going back here, okay? Right-click to close. I will deselect it and reduce here, something like this. I will select it and position it better. That's it. Now, since it's quite narrow, I will change the option path direction mode from both to forward. Okay, I will set actor can to 3 and then click generate. So now spacebar, and as you can see, there are characters coming down. So you could create several paths, one coming down, other coming going up, and so on and so forth. Okay, so it's very simple to create this kind of situation. And what if I have a model, a bigger model? Let's say that this tribune is a lot bigger. So what we could do is to start with this area, small area, so we can set it quite fast, and then extend it. Okay, like what? Well, for example, we select this, and then just extend this, and we have a lot more cells. So what we should do is just to select this, okay, and click generate, of course, increasing the actor count, and this will be populated perfectly, okay? So I will hit Ctrl-Z and just escape to have this done. So I hope you have understood that in this case, Anima shows us that we can use tools meant for one purpose for another one, okay? So the idea is for me to tell you to explore different ways of using these elements, combining them, and to use them a bit more in a less traditional way, okay? So for this video, we stop here. See you soon.